Howdy folks, and welcome back to Let's Play Fallout 3. As per usual, we're just gonna jump right back in here and see what is what. As per protocol, Outrider has told me that in this area that we're in, apparently there is a shop to sell stuff at and there's a doctor, as well as the beginning of a new quest line, which is pretty tempting to me because now that we are done with Moira,
always busted.
It's kinda... yeah, not a lot to do. Hey, Underworld Outfitters. All right.
Long time no see. Oh, a human. Well, hello. Welcome to Underworld Outfitters. It's been so long since I had a customer.
All right. Well, what do you have for sale?
Sure thing, human.
Possibly something. This Action Abe action figure. Oh my God, that and between that and Corporal Punishment. I'm gonna have, like, a little doll factory going in my house. Apartment, whatever it is. Okay, we do have a bunch of junk that we can actually just kind of offload here. So I guess we're gonna do that. Okay. I keep forgetting to turn in all these fingers. And I'm sure I will continue to do so. Got a couple lever-action rifles. I'm gonna sell this crappy one. Also have Lincoln's repeater. That's gonna be... I'm happy about that, believe me. I've wanted to pick that thing up basically since we got out of the vault. So, didn't mean to sell things there. Whatever. Pre-war book. I do not want to sell the pre-war books. Those are worth substantially more money turning them in. I'm glad I caught myself. This machine pistol... uses 32 ammo. Well, assuming 32 ammo is 32 caliber rounds, let me go up and say, yeah. Okay, so I might hold on to that, get it repaired, and use that as my my pistol replacement for my Magnum. I'm gonna miss having that thing, but what are you gonna do? Scroll on a stick, we can get rid of sugar bombs. Do not need surgical supplies. I'm gonna hold on to the travel healing powder or whatever. We might find a use for it at some point. Okay, so we've got some money. And she's got some bullets. I'm just gonna buy all of those. Whatever.
A pleasure doing business.
Okay, we gotta go. Alright, and apparently there is a doctor in the back who will start us a quest. The chop shop. I'm gonna go ahead and guess that this is the doctor's. And he said that this will start a quest, Riley's Rangers. So this will give us something to do. Doctor.
Dr. Barrows, at your service. What brings you to the chop shop? Come to lend me a hand, I hope. I can always use fresh human samples.
What? What do you mean, fresh human samples?
You haven't heard? I'm the foremost authority on ghoul evolution. I want to know what makes us tick. Something doomed us to this rotting form, and I aim to discover what it is. So, I need samples of human skin, organs, and other parts to make the experiments valid.
Sorry, but I aim to keep all my samples to myself.
Pity. Well then, what can I do for you?
Okay. See, I don't think we really need anything from
him. Be careful now.
Kind of pester people. Hey, there's a human in here. No response. She's in some sort of a coma.
I'm afraid she's going to be out for a while. She's not well at all. Don't worry, though. I'm sure the rest of Riley's Rangers will show up soon and take her home.
Okay, Riley's Rangers.
Oh, you must be new around here. They're a mercenary company that bases itself out of the DC ruins. I'm assuming she's their leader, Riley. What was left of her armor had her name stenciled on it. She was in a pretty bad way when they found her outside Underworld.
What's wrong with her?
She had multiple lacerations, contusions, broken leg, some internal bleeding, and blunt force trauma. She hasn't been conscious since they brought her in a few days ago.
Sounds like she got an
tangled with some super mutants and lost. It's a miracle she isn't dead.
That's what I was gonna say. As soon as the blunt force trauma hit, I'm like, that sounds like a super mutant with a power sledge. Okay, do you think there's any way to revive her?
Well, I wouldn't recommend it. She's in some sort of coma. It's dangerous to force someone out of one. There's no telling when she'll come out of it, I'm afraid.
Okay, how'd she end up in the chop shop?
She was just brought in by a few others. They found her bleeding to death at the entrance to the city here. If she'd been out in the tunnels any longer, she'd have been someone's meal by now.
Okay, thanks. We're not gonna be able to get this. No, that's not gonna work.
No problem, just don't disturb the patients.
Okay. Well, there's Riley. Who are you?
Welcome to the chop shop. I'm Nurse Graves, Dr. Borrow's assistant.
Nurse Ratchet.
Don't let our place's name fool you. The doctor is very good with injuries, dismemberments, and trauma. If you require any stim packs or blood packs, let me know.
Okay, what can you tell me about Riley?
Poor girl. I didn't think she'd make it through the first night she was brought in here. Dr. Burrows has done everything in his power to keep her alive.
Why does he care so much about humans, anyways?
The doctor is convinced that the key to curing our appearance is locked within the human body. When Riley was brought in here, he saw a chance to put that theory to the test.
He's experimenting on her? That's kind of twisted.
First and foremost on Dr. Borrow's mind is her health and well-being. I can assure you of that. So far, none of his conclusions are finalized, but the tests he's running are coming up quite positive. Oh, I shouldn't be telling you any of this.
Well, why not?
Well, some of the ghouls in Underworld object to what the doctor is doing. They think ghouls are ghouls and humans are humans. Like we were meant to be this way. Some have even threatened the doctor. I'm afraid one day something might happen to him.
Interesting.
Not impressed, hmm? Oh well, I didn't expect a human to understand the gravity of this experiment anyway. Just do me a favor and don't mention this to anyone. No telling what reaction this could have if it got out.
Sure, I gotta go.
Later.
Okay. So, that's not creepy at all. Doctor experimenting on people. Oh my god, is it?
Accessing threat.
Accessing threat? You mean assessing threat there, maybe, Cerberus? Okay. Well, in that case, we're going to kind of poke around DC and see if we can find these rangers and maybe let them know that she's here being experimented on by ghouls. That's just nice. I don't suppose it's actually like a quest. No. No, it is not. I suppose we can kind of start meandering down towards the National Archive. I think that's further on down this way. Go ahead and check the map. Yes. Alright, pull out our spiffy new rifle here. Can't wait to use this to maybe explode some super mutant heads. Should be pretty glorious. I think we're cleared up to about here. Because, yeah, there's the museum over there. Alright, so. Well, I'm sure that's just a war zone over there. Let's see what we've got over here. I think this is the National Archives right here, actually. I want to kind of approach carefully, keeping my eyes on the ground for like mines and stuff. Possible ambush. Yep. National Archives. Called that. Kind of just poke around a little bit. See what we've got back here. Oh, looks like a little side area. We'll check that out. Ranger emergency frequency radio. Really? Radio. Ranger. Oh, here we go. Find Rylan. Oh my god, I already did that, though. Dang it. Seriously, game? Seriously. Whatever. We'll futz with that later. Okay, so it doesn't really look like there's too much back here. Oh, we've got a subway entrance, which I'm not going to even remotely deal with. Had quite enough of the subways. That is one thing that I will say that I miss in New Vegas, though, is the subways in this kind of array. They, like, give the game excuses to have, like, quote-unquote dungeons, whereas New Vegas, not so much. Well, I hear something. Over there. Oh. Fudge. I saw it just as... Oh, that's what I heard. Okay. Man, I hate these floaters. Like, I don't know what it is, but, like, their hitboxes are just so freaking janky. Oh, I'm gonna die. Now. 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 Yeah, I saw that coming. Alright. Alright. In that case, I'm just gonna do this. Get away! Get away! Bring triple everything. What? Oh! What is this? They're like, for some reason the game is not letting me go into vats or anything and just, oh, I'm gonna get wasted again. Yeah. Saw that coming. Okay, so that time there was an abominable to my right, and somehow it didn't set off the fragmentation mines that are like all over the place over there. Okay. I think that maybe, just maybe, this is a situation for shotgun. And I'm just gonna blast the god out of everything. Oh, a cursed reload. Okay. Ow. Oh! Jesus Christ! I don't know why my gun just decided to discharge there. Man, there is just all kinds of stuff in here. Alright. Wow. Quick save. Well, there's another one. Let's see here. That's worth it. Almost out of ammo on that thing. I have to...
No more games! Time to die!
Okay. Oh, Super Mutant Behemoth. I should probably be glad that he's stuck. I'm gonna, however, shoot this thing in the dome. Tentatively. Jeez. I don't even know. Just blew his buddy's head off. I'm just glad this sucker's stuck on the train because, like, I'm shooting him in the head and it's not doing anything. Maybe a grenade. Yeah. Yeah, I just don't think he can get to me. I think this is like, yeah, he just is incapable of... Like, look at that! Look at that! Hey, there's not even anything in there that... Oh my god, I really want... And his hitbox is, like, way too big. Okay, well, I know I'm in here for, like, the Declaration of Independence. And knowing my luck, it's probably carrying it. Morphine. Wow, yeah, why my meat is just worth a crap load of money there. Hey! Seriously? I got bumped by a carcass and it's like, no, you're eating some damage for that. Okay, whatever. He can just stay over there, stuck in his room. I'm gonna leave him alone. I've already wasted enough bullets on him. Flip on my Pip-Boy light here. Nonfiction. I'm just looking for non-destroyed books. I am not seeing them. Sadly. Okay. Okay. Whatever. So just a little trap here. My favorite thing to do in Oblivion, they had traps like this, and you could use the in-game manipulation key, like that you'd use for like picking stuff up, like this. You could actually use it to stop battering rams and stuff. I got really good at like catching them right as they were flying at my face. That was a long time ago, though. I'm just gonna crack. This should not be. Yeah, I was gonna say that should not be anything. Some ibuprofen, that was kind of a waste, but at least we got some experience points out of it, so I guess not entirely a waste, but kind of crappy. Hello, random. Probably wants a trap. Head and... Oh, we got some bullets. Ammo boxes. Damn it, I do not want to breach the lock. Crack this stupid thing. So microfusion cells, pulse grenades, frag grenades, Nuka-Cola. And more microfusion cells. Because you can never have enough of those. They sell for a lot though, so I'm not gonna complain too much. Okay. Some shotgun shells, 40 of them. That pleases me, and a combat shotgun, which I'm slightly less excited about, but I'm glad to have some shoddy ammo now. Ugh. Oh, that was a fucking... Just botched that. Whoa! Grenade physics in this are just horrible. Oh, hey. Oh, come on, Devon. Oh. Sometimes I just want to smack him. All right. So, okay, there's that. We're not going to worry about that. Let's see here. Got everything off of you. So I don't think there was really anything too useful. That's the battering ram door. Take that. Flip on my Pip-Boy light. Let's go ahead and grab... Oh, I missed these darts my first time. And a medical brace. God, I'm not even paying attention, I swear. Take the ibuprofen. And I think that was it for in here. Then we want, let's see, I think this was microfusion cells. Oh my god, I wanted to pick the lock. I swear that like the order on these changes like every time. Okay, so we got some fragmentation grenades. Switch on over to those. More microfusion cells. Let's see, this should be the stairs. Yes, okay. So first things first, could drop into a crouch. I don't know where that super mutant was. Oh. I think I just erased that one's head. This one I'm probably not gonna do so well on because, hey, I crippled his head. That counts for something. And boom! Man, I wish that the gun physics in this, like, even with the mods kind of toning them down, as you can see, they're still pretty intense. Okay. First aid box, surgical supplies, some diazepam, and a blood pack. I suppose I can go ahead and eat that blood pack, because why not? Could use some healing. Okay, I actually want to check really quick my special perception. Bonus to lockpick energy weapon skills, agility is small guns. Okay, I'm actually going to use, in that case, some tribal healing powder as well. I'm actually going to use two of those, so that should heal us, I want to say, roughly to full health. Okay. Kinda. Take it easy here, don't want to go too fast. I wonder if, that's not traps me. Looks like gut, maybe. Yeah. Microfusion cells. Your repair skill allows you to grab without getting shocked. Alright, sure. Cool. So we're apparently good enough at repairing now that we could disarm a trap. And this first aid kit is empty. Our repair isn't even that high, I don't think. 50. Alright, our repair is actually higher than I thought it was. I know we bumped it last level, but I didn't think I had bumped it.
Now try and hide from this.
Where is he? I know I'm gonna get, like, jumped, and then I'm gonna, like, spaz the hell out, because that's what I do. Oh, I'm gonna eat one in the face. I'm just gonna aim for, like, center of mass on this dude. Come on. You got a third, or maybe not. Ah! Jeez. Man, I took a super sledge swing to the face. Thankfully, we've got tribal medicine and all kinds of crap in us to keep us kicking. Scrap metal, sensor module, bottle cap. Anything else out here? No. Let's see if these guys. Yeah, some 32 ammo. All right. Vicious pup fur. I don't care about. Actually, I am reminded, however, that I want to switch this away. Oh, I actually do have the machine pistol already set up in there. Sweet. A little Uzi. Oh, hey, look, it's another one of my freaking Uber shotties. Well, I'm gonna take that and see if. Let's see here, where's mine? Cannot repair equipment like combat. What? Didn't realize I was in the middle of a gunfight here, but apparently I am. I kinda wanna test out this pistol, that's why I've got it out. I'm sure it's gonna end up getting me killed, though. Go ahead and quick save again. Yeah, that's probably the one that's down. It's probably, like, right below me right now or something. Or there's multiples in here. I don't know. Okay. That is a super mutant gargantuan. Yeah. Okay. Oh, crap. Alright, so I'm just gonna come down here, and we're just gonna go ahead and do that. Wow. I guess, thank God for doors. Because without them, I would be dead. Okay, here's some mentats, an ammo box, an empty ammo box, that's disappointing. Okay, what do we got here? Oh, shit. Oh, my limbs. Ugh. 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 Where's my freaking morphine? Jesus. If I'm gonna become addicted to anything, it's gonna be friggin' morphine, because my limbs are crippled always. Wait, what was that? I saw stuff in there. 32 ammo, sweet. Some bottle caps and a Nuka-Cola. We got in here some 308 ammo, a bottle cap, and a sack of weed. Value 75 caps. All right, I'll take that. And then Gargantuan is like following me down the stairs or something. I don't know. Okay, and we have an elevator to archival strong room. Of course, it requires a key. I'm sure that key is upstairs in that room guarded by the Gargantuan, because game developers are jerks. Or maybe it's through here, I don't know. Well, he's dead. What the hell happened? Watch out for the mines. Quick, they're coming. What? Oh god, no! Oh. Watch out for the mines. Alright, and then she's like, quick, they're coming. And I'm like, oh shit! Okay, so where are the mines? There's a mine. I just need, like... Yeah. Okay, whatever you say. I'm gonna go ahead and leave a couple mines behind me here. Come on, stand up! Devon refusing to stand. Oh, there's another one. Oh, there's two. Oh! See that? Freaking professionalism, I grabbed them both. I grabbed that one too. Oh, you f- Seriously, oh, apparently things are in fact coming. Man, I don't know, this is like ridiculous. How am I supposed to freaking do this? There's a bunch over there, there's one there, there's one there, and there, and there. Okay. I'm just gonna attempt to jump over this barricade that the game's movement system is making much harder to do.
Lock and load, they'll be here any second.
Okay.
Hey! Look out!
I know what I'm doing.
Hang tight. There's always a second wave. Hey! Find them. Yeah! Yeah!
Oh my god, it's got a rocket launcher. What the sheesh? My god, I pooped a little. Alright, who the hell are you?
Whew. Say, you're pretty decent in a firefight.
Abe Lincoln guides my hands.
Well, with what I do for a living, you need to be. Sorry, I'm being a complete asshole. I'm Sydney. It's good to meet a fellow relic hunter.
Oh god, what do you mean, relic hunter?
Come on. You and I both know this is where the Declaration of Independence is stashed. No need to be coy about it. Good old Abraham Washington sent you on the same suicide mission he sent me on.
Oh.
Only problem is, you're not going to get it without my help.
What are you proposing?
Simple. We pool our resources, grab the Declaration, then make for Rivet City and split the reward. I've studied the plans of this place. So without me, you're going to go in circles. What do you say?
See, I'm of two minds of this. I'm like, one, yeah, sure, I could use an extra gun, but I'm also, I bet you she's gonna try to shoot me as soon as we get it. But Devon would assume that, but he wouldn't just, like, kill her. So I guess, sure, why not?
Smart move. Okay, the Declaration is secured in the archive strong room underground.
What a twist.
There's a concealed cargo lift right here in the center of the rotunda. I've spent a few days hacking the lock with my remote terminal. When you're ready, punch in the password, let's get going.
Alright. Let's get going.
Keep your eyes on the mission, and off my ass, please.
What? Okay. Well. Hey, bullets. Yoink. Let's see, is there anything else we need around here? Schematics, junk metal saber. Alright. I'm tempted to come through here and collect all of these mines, because if I don't, I'm going to end up trying to leave and run right into them. So I think we're going to go ahead and grab as many of these things as is reasonably possible here, and then I'm going to call it an episode. And no, Outrider, I'm not going to record hour-long episodes. No. Just no.
Help me!
What?
Look out!
What?
Doesn't matter, huh? Can't stand the sight of your own blood.
What? Is there like another behemoth out here or something? Where did she go? Oh. Phasing through doors. Oh, this stupid woman.
Where?
Yeah, who saw that coming? Wow, if I didn't know anything any better, I'd say that thing was actually regenerating. And she's over there, like, unconscious. So, okay. She can just sit there doing her own thing. I'm gonna finish looting the bodies and call it an episode. Shotgun shells. Get out of the pile of corpses. Come on now. I need to be able to access loot. Yeah, the dude did have a freaking missile launcher. Oh my god. And a flamer. Jeez. That is one heavily armed super mutant. Come on. Come on. Couple of them missing their domes. I wonder how that happened. Okay. Go ahead and quick save. I was gonna say, because I know there's more. Oh, there was an extra one. Thankfully, I'm like all coked up and I don't feel pain anymore. Okay. Let's go ahead and enter this password. Activate it. Unlock the cargo lift. Okay. Gonna go ahead and quick save. And I think this is episode 23. I'm gonna go ahead and check really quick. Yes. Alright. 1, 2, 3. And we will call it here. So, as per usual, folks, thank you for watching. Next time, dear God, I don't even know. I will see you all then, though.